males can go into the female bathrooms under some circumstances, depending on how you categorize yourself. And it has created a great deal of difficulty for the school systems in the state of South Dakota as they try and grapple with these issues. And the ACLU and the federal and the Department of Obama's Department of Justice are essentially saying that you have to allow that. And so in a number of federal laws, they talk about reasonable accommodations. That what you do is when you have someone that has, for instance, under the ADA or something of that nature, a disability, that as an employer or as a governmental entity, that what you do is you give those people a reasonable accommodation that doesn't infringe upon the rights of the other employees or the other people affected. And so what this bill tries to do is create or carve out an opportunity for the school districts of the state and the other governmental entities to give a reasonable accommodation without infringing upon the rights of the rest of us. And I think that, I really think I struggled with the bill. I studied it when I got a copy of it from the good representative from Eastern South Dakota, and I thought, you know what, that makes a lot of sense. I think that he put a lot of thought into it. They worked through a number of attorneys. It's obvious that they did that at the national level, that are experts in this area based upon what's been going on. So I feel very good about, I'm proud to be a sponsor of the bill. And I think that it may not be perfect, but I think that it's a step in the right direction. And we frankly need to have this discussion about what's appropriate and how we essentially split the baby or try and find that middle ground so that everybody can function and that nobody's discriminated against and nobody's rights are infringed. And I don't necessarily. Well, first, three things. First of all, the whole issue of transgender is incredibly difficult, and I'm sure that most of you are like me, that, you know, it's hard to sort of wrap your arms around it. If you're as old as I am, it's even harder. I mean, when I was in school, transgender was that dirty word in the dictionary that somebody circled, sort of thing. It's really a hard issue for us to comprehend and work it. The other thing that I think is happening here is that this bill, of course, if it becomes law, will certainly be a lightning rod for legal action. And I don't think we should be afraid to have legal action if we're doing the right thing, but I'm also not so sure that we ought to sort of invite and sort of wear as a badge of honor bringing legal action on the state and expending state resources in an issue where we might not have to do that. Finally, I would say that, and to your comment, is that I haven't seen that this is a problem. And maybe it hasn't, if this has come into the Senate side, maybe I'll see that testimony. But we have transgender students in our schools now, and I have not heard of that not being handled appropriately by local officials. And I think schools are the right place to work out what's best for everybody. I'm not sure exactly what that is. I'm sure it's different in different schools and different situations. But as far as I can tell, schools have been doing a good job of working through this issue. And frankly, so I think at this point, it's not an issue that I think the legislature needs to be involved in. Thank you.